It's your mindset. Your mind will be, if your mindset is disconnected, that my hands, you will not sin against God. I will not use my hands to sin against God. My hands are blessed with the blessings of the Lord. Anyone I touch must be blessed. Not this hands you will use to kill. Not this hands you will use to commit abortion. Not this hands you use to steal money. Not this hands you use to collect bribes, as Sam said. No. Tell your hands, and you cannot make me to go to hell. I refuse you from making me to go to hell, because I am born again by the grace of God. Point number two. Not to abstain from all appearance of evil or forms of evil. Number two. Jesus said in Mark 9:45, he said, cut off your foot. Or cut off your feet. Cut it off. If your feet will make you to sin, do what? Cut it off. It is better for you to go into heaven without legs or with one leg than to enter hell with two legs. What would you prefer? But Jesus Christ is not telling you today to go and cut your feet off. He's telling you today, avoid going to places and walking with people that will lead you to sin. Avoid going to places and working with people that will lead you to what? To sin. Avoid them completely. Light and darkness has no relationship. Praise God. Psalm 1. I'm going to read. Psalm division 1. Let us see Psalm 1. The Bible of us. Blessed are those who walk not in the counsel. Blessed is the man that walketh not in the counsel of the ungodly, nor standeth in the ways of sinners, nor sitteth in the seat of the scornful. Blessed is the man that walketh not in the counsel of what? Of the ungodly. The man that walketh not in the counsel of the ungodly. You don't walk with them. These people are sinners. There's no relationship between light and darkness. There's no relation between righteousness and unrighteousness. Don't forget, you are a righteous person through the imputed righteousness you have in Christ. And so you have no relationship to walk with unrighteous people. Now that does not mean we cannot. What the Bible is saying here, that you disconnect yourself and so on and so forth, is having intimate relationship. Very close relationship. Your purpose of relating with people who are sinners is the purpose to win them to Christ. If you're always in their midst at all times, you joke with them, you drink with them, you party with them, every place they go, you go with them. I mean, you are always surrounded by them. And you have not opened your mouth to say Jesus Christ. You are doing what? You are walking in the counsel of the ungodly. And the opposite of a blessing is what? It's a curse. And if you continue in that relationship, it will lead you to the lake of fire. That will not be your portion in Jesus' name. Amen. Proverbs chapter 1. Now look at this one. Very interesting. Very, very interesting. Proverbs chapter 1. I'm getting to the end of the message gradually. Proverbs chapter 1. Proverbs 1. Look at it. Look what the Bible says. It said, my son, verse 10. If sinners entice thee, consent thou not. 11. If they say, come with us, let us lay wait for blood. Let us flow privily for the innocent without cause. Let us swallow them up alive as the grave and whole, as those that go down into the pit. We shall find this and that. Look at verse 15. He said, my son, walk not thou in the way with them. Refrain thy foot from their path. If sinners entice you, consent not. Refrain your foot. Refuse to go. I cannot use my feet to sin against God. Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Finally, for you to abstain from every appearance of evil, the Bible says, pluck out your eye. Mark 9:47. Pluck out your eye. Mark 9:47. Pluck out your eye. What does that mean? Avoid steady look on evil things. Avoid steady look on what? Evil things. Jesus Christ said in Matthew chapter 5, from verse 27 to 29, he said, any man, I'm paraphrasing that, any man who looks at a woman lustfully has already committed, and let us read it. Let us read it so that you will see it. I heard that it was in the Bible, but I've not seen it. It's Matthew chapter 5. Let us read it. You see, this is why I said something I like to read the Bible, because I want us to see these things ourselves and then get it clearly. Matthew chapter 5. I'm reading from verse 27. And I'm going to end verse 28. Oh, let me end 29 so that you get what to say. Matthew 5, 27 to 29. He said, ye have heard that it was said by them of old, thou shalt not commit adultery. But I say unto you, Jesus Christ speaking, that whosoever looketh on a woman to lust after her hath committed adultery with her already in his heart. And if thy right eye offend thee, pluck it out and cast it from thee. For it is profitable for thee that one of thy members should perish, and not that thy whole body should be cast into hell. You understand what Jesus Christ is saying here? He's not saying physically remove it. He said if you lust after a woman. So that means anything that will make you to look steadily on sin. David in 2 Samuel chapter 11. The Bible says David came one of the days when the people had gone to war, and he was walking in his balcony. When he got there, he saw a woman bathing. As he saw the woman bathing, he thought of David to say, ah, no. Run back to his room. David stood there and was looking at the woman from head to toe. And David committed adultery with the woman just by looking at the woman. And he went further to invite the woman into his house. And he slept with the woman. And the woman became pregnant. Hey, brothers and sisters. Pluck out your eyes. Don't look steadily at things. There are some people in here, they are looking at things, Not only women, looking for some other things, they want to steal it. If somebody just come and the person is just looking at you, maybe looking at your phone, looking at your resources, say, ah, now wow. Ah, the person is planning to do what to steal it. The eye has connected your body. It's the eye that saw it. If the eye did not see your wristwatch, if the eye did not see your phone, will they go and steal it? No. But the eye has seen it. The person refused. Ah, no. He look at this. Ah, that thing will reach almost 100 pounds. Oh, but if I sell this 100 pounds now, I have money. You know what I'm trying to say? The eye. Pluck out that eye. Avoid steady look on things. On evil things. Things that will make you to sin. Let us conclude by reading the book of Job. I like this man. What the word Job said. Job chapter 31. Look at what he said from verse 1. He said he has made a covenant with his eye. Job 31 verse 1. He said, I made a covenant with my eyes. Why then should I think upon a maid? I have decided within me. Now what you will do like Job. You have to avoid. You make a covenant with your eyes. This eye, you will not cause me to sin. I have made a covenant with my eyes. In other words, I have covenanted with this eye. That this eye is not going to see evil. He said, now why will I look on a maid? And why will I look on a woman? For a man. And for a woman. Why will you look at, why will you look at a man? You think it's only a man that lusts after women. Women lust after men. Women lust after men. I forgot somebody was telling me that some group of girls, they were seated one place. A guy was just passing. They were just saying some type of nonsense things about the guy. Say, look at him. This, I mean, they were attracted to that guy. They wanted the guy to come to them. They wanted that guy to be their boyfriend. Lost him. As well, good, this guy is good though. He's well built. This and that. You know, they were saying something. This person overheard them saying that. Lost him. Tell your eyes. Eyes, I will not lust. Let us rise up to pray. We're going to pray a very serious prayer right now. And I want you to pray it with the depth of your heart. You have seen the steps you need to take to remain born again, finally. And then you're going to pray this prayer. You're going to pray this prayer seriously. You spirit of backsliding, I command you in the name of Jesus, be paralyzed and be buried now. In the name of Jesus, pray that prayer for yourself. Everything that want to make you backslide, refuse it today. You spirit of backsliding, I command you in the name of the Lord Jesus, be paralyzed and be buried now in the name of Jesus. I said be paralyzed and be buried now in the name of Jesus. Every spirit of backsliding trying to push me to go back to the world. I am not going back to the world. I refuse to go back to the world. You that spirit be paralyzed right now and be buried right now in the name of Jesus. In Jesus' name we pray.